Well, some people have asked me, well, where are the toughest people in Wagga? Some people have thought, well, maybe the skate park. Others think, well, maybe it's the RSL. But really, those places have got nothing compared to a fighting gym. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into this fighting gym and we're going to find some really tough people and we're going to ask them some questions. So let's come.
Is pretty much the hardest thing I ever do, so I can't really compare fights, except they involve both being mentally tough, emotionally tough, physically tough obviously, and also spiritually tough, because you have to have so much faith in yourself and all your supporters. So every time I hop in that ring, it's drawing on all those four things, and that's got to be the hardest thing.
Toughest thing I've probably done was, like, as you can see here, you know, starting up here and having a fight under Liam Priest, you know, it was a good experience, great experience.
Probably my toughest fight was my last fight. I fought for an Australian title in Shepparton. The dude in the second round kicked the hell out of my left arm. That went numb from the shoulder down and I couldn't feel it for two rounds. Managed to pull the fight back. Controversial, you got a draw, thought I'd won.
It was probably when I thought I'd broken my foot in the third round, and later on it turned out I had serious hematoma, so it was pretty serious, but I continued. Like, I could have chosen to stop there on the fight and have a technical knockout, but it was in front of a home crowd, there was a lot of pressure. I wanted to please and do what I'd trained for, so I continued on a knee broken foot for another two rounds.
Yep. So there's some bruises from fighting.
My worst injury, as you can probably tell, I've broken my nose several times, probably about 20.
I've fractured my hand, so I can't actually notice it now, but I've, like, thrown an overhand on top of his head and sort of hit in an awkward position and sort of fractured my hand, not too bad, but real painful for the next couple of days.
I remember one fight, I got kneed in the head so bad that I had an egg on my head from about there to my forehead line, and it took 3 weeks to come out from being kneed in the face.
Well, as tough as those people were, I didn't think they were near as tough as Jesus. So starting on the 23rd of April, from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m, every Friday night, St. Paul's Youth Group is going to look at the final hours in the life of Jesus. He went through many trials. He was betrayed by his friends. He was ultimately crucified, and he actually came back to life. So tell your friends about it, and we're going to see Jesus sweating it out to be the real King of the Ring.